in this video, we're going to be showing you how to paint the Askurgan Exemplar, so they are ready to lead their warband in battle against great monsters and foes. The first thing we've done is undercoat our model, and for this scheme we've used grey sear. This will give us a great base coat for the pale skin and for the contrast colours. It's also a good idea to have the base paint that matches the spray to hand, to tidy up any mistakes. The paints you need are on the screen right now. Remember that these are our recommendations, feel free to paint these miniatures however you like. If you are new to painting or want to know the paints and techniques used in this video, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos in the description. First, we'll apply Rakar flesh to the skin and bone adornments with our small base brush. As we're applying it over grey sear, we'll only need a thin layer of this paint, as it will cover well over the lighter colour. Just make sure we have covered the bony rib area under the armour plate and around that heraldic adornment. Don't worry if you get any of it on the robes of the model, but try and avoid the inner cloth, hair and rope belt, as we want to keep that clean for our next colours. Rakar flesh is a great colour for the pallid skin of the undead, but you can pick any colour you want. Next, we'll be using Griffhound Orange for the inner cloth of the robe. We'll get a good amount on our small base brush and get it all into those folds of the cloth. You can also add another coat if you want the orange to be a bit darker. As you can see, we have got some of it on the rest of the robe and the rope belt, as it's a bit difficult to get the orange contrast without making a mess. This is totally fine and can be tidied up really easily with the grey sear base paint after the contrast is dry. We can also add another thin layer of Griffhound Orange if you find it's too light on the raised areas and you want it darker. With the contrast dry, we can move on to Corvus Black for the robes, shoes, inside of the chest plate and the black stripe in his hair. For larger areas like the robe, we're going to use our small base brush, and for those smaller details we'll be using our small layer brush. This is so we can avoid getting any Corvus Black on the already painted areas, and we also want to keep the rest of the hair grey sear for later. Don't worry about the black on the chest plate being neat either, as we'll be covering most of it in another colour later. As Corvus Black is a slightly lighter black, it's going to look great when we add some shading over it later, creating some simple highlights so we don't have to highlight our cloth. Next, we'll apply Soul Bright Grey over the ropes and the white hair. We'll start with a thin layer of the shade, then once it's dry we can add more in those deeper recesses, especially around the rope knot to add a bit more depth. If we have applied too much, we can always remove some while it's wet using a damp clean brush. Soul Bright Grey is a great shade for going over lighter colours, for simple recessed shadows without making it too dark. Now we'll use Iron Warriors for the armour, the blades, the heraldic adornment, tassets and some of the rings and bracelets. By using our small layer brush, we can get into those hard to reach places and avoid anything that's already painted, especially those ropes we just shaded. We'll give this colour a couple of layers so we can build up that solid metal dark tone. Iron Warriors is perfect for the dark, strong metal that the Askurgans use for their warrior arts of battle against the beasts of Gur. With Iron Warriors dry, we can apply Skull Crusher Brass to the other metallic details, such as the blade hilts, hair decoration, and other rings and bracelets. Just like Iron Warriors, we want to build up a couple of layers to get a nice solid colour, using our small layer brush, so we don't get any of that paint on those hands. These are very small details, so don't worry if you do get some on the skin, we can easily tidy up with the previous steps. Now is the best time to change our paint water, to avoid any metallic flakes getting into our next paints. With our water changed, we can thin down some Black Legion for applying over the Corvus Black and Iron Warriors. We'll be using 3 parts water to 1 part Black Legion, as we want the mix to cover like a heavy shade. We'll apply it to the recesses of the black cloth to give some darker shadows, and we'll apply it all over the Iron Warriors, making that metal even darker. Black Legion is a very heavy black contrast, but by thinning it down with various amounts of water, we can get different shades that we can apply over many different colours, giving us many different effects and uses. After the Black Legion is dry, we'll highlight the silver metal with Stormhost Silver. We'll get our small layer brush to a sharp point by rolling it on the palette. This also makes sure that we don't have too much paint on our brush too. We'll use the side of the brush for most of the lines around the armor plating and blades, giving it a sharp, neat edge. This is a quick and easy way to edge highlight. Remember that you don't have to highlight every area, you can do as much or as little as you want. If you don't want such a bright silver edge, you can use Runefang Steel or Iron Breaker instead. Next, we'll use Agrax Earthshade in two ways. We'll use it straight out of the pot for the ends of the rope and the orange cloth, to give it a dirty effect as they've been dragged through the Gnarlwood's forest floor. Then we'll use 2 parts water and 1 part Agrax Earthshade for a lighter shade, to use over the brass details and the recesses of the skin and the eye sockets. We'll try to avoid those raised areas of muscle though, by using our small layer brush. Just like before, if you get too much on the skin, you can remove it with a clean, damp brush. If it's too dark on the raised areas of muscle, leave it to dry and then we can apply some Rakkar flesh over to tidy up. Now that our model is painted, we can add a little extra detail if you feel confident for that extra bite of colour. For that little bit of spookiness, we'll be using Fire Dragon Bright for some glowing eyes. We'll add a small dot of paint over the shaded eye sockets with our small layer brush. You can have any colour eyes you wish. We picked Fire Dragon Bright as we've already got orange in our colour scheme, so they tie together with the rest of the model, and it doesn't add too many different colours to our pallid undead warband. And there we are, your Askurgan Exemplar is finished and looking awesome. You can see that our model is based in Stirling mud, but you can base it in any colours you want. If you'd like to learn more about basing, check out our technical paints video all about it. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!